Hey, Bobcat fans. Welcome to this year's second episode of Bobcats Weekly. I'm your host, John Orsenega.
And I'm Justin Cloutier.
Justin, it was another busy week for the Quinnipiac team, so let's get right to it.
Let's do it, John. Postseason play opened up this past weekend with Quinnipiac women's soccer upsetting Siena 1-0 in the semifinal round of the MAC championship. Unfortunately for the Bobcats, they lost in the final to number one ranked Monmouth 5-2. Congratulations to the team for their historic season.
This week's results weren't all good, but we still got to see our share of exciting highlight reel plays. Let's take a look now at our top five plays of the week.
Let's go, John. Why don't you take the odds this week?
Sounds good to me. Let's start things off on the ice with men's hockey. Tim Clifton takes the pass on the left side and wrists one 5-hole for the goal.
We stay on the ice for play number four. Sophomore star Melissa Samuskevich battles to get the puck up to Katie Tabin, where she rifles the puck through traffic to score against Clarkson.
Women's soccer at number three, Jess Gargan's got a free kick from about 40 yards away, and check this out. It goes over everyone's head, the goalie's out of position and into the back of the net.
Yeah, number two, Al Pelletier battles off a Siena defender and toe pokes this one past the keeper to clinch a spot in the MAC championship game. Let's see that one again, John. Gets this ball off the half volley and toe pokes it into the net. What a goal.
And our top play of the week, men's soccer. Ryan Scheiderman with the free kick, bends it around the wall and into the lower left-hand corner of the goal. Get off me. Let's take a look at that again. Quinnipiac goes on to beat Fairfield 1-0 and clinch the MAC regular season title, their fourth conference title in the last 5 years.
Wow, quite some top plays there, John.
Absolutely, great stuff.
When we come back, Nicole Kessler will be interviewing Taylor Schussler from the women's rugby team. Stick with us. We'll be right back with Bobcats Weekly. Welcome back. It's that time of the show where we send it over to Nicole for our interview of the week. Nicole?
Thanks, guys. I'm Nicole Kessler, and I'm here with women's rugby player Taylor Schussler. Taylor, thank you for coming on the show.
Thank you for having me, Nicole.
So, you guys had an historic win this past week. How did that make you feel?
It's one of those things where the rugby community is very small, so everyone knows everyone, and you know, we have friends from Penn State, we have friends from other teams too, but Penn State's always kind of been thought of as this dynasty. You know, they've won the USA championships like 11 years in a row or something, so be able to come in and beat them, and beat them significantly in my eyes was one of the coolest things that we've done as a program in a while. But you know, it was better because it was the whole team had a hand in it. No one played individualistically. It was 100% a team win. And I think it really just, you know, pulled us closer together. And overall, it was a great team win. But, you know, we're just taking the win for what it is. It's another mark in the W column. And we have to move forward and focus on quarterfinals now and the national championship. So
this week coming up, you guys are playing in the NIRA playoffs. What are your thoughts going into this, especially because you're a senior?
As a senior, it's a little different for me because I come back for my master's for a fifth year. So I'll be a super senior next year. But I know that the opportunity to go to the national tournament every year is super special. We had a great opportunity, and it was so cool to do it as an inaugural thing last year. But to be able to go back-to-back and have a repeat is, you know, it's one of those things where it's kind of like a storybook ending. And, you know, quarterfinals coming up is our first match at Westchester this weekend. And, you know, you have to take it opponent by opponent. But I know that the whole team is really stoked to be able to be back and to do it again. So, you know, just take everything with a grain of salt, and we have to celebrate everything that we do and look on to the next. So.
Yep. And defend that national title.
Yeah.
So thank you so much for coming on the show. I know the Bobcats are wishing you the best of luck. Back to you guys at the desk.
Thanks, Nicole. Wow, John, it's always a pleasure to have a great player like Schussler in the building.
Oh, absolutely. And what a job by women's rugby again this season, beating Penn State, their first loss to a college team in 5 years. Incredible. When we return, Tyler Brocious will be back for his Bobcat of the Week segment, this time on the pitch. You don't want to miss this.
What's happening, guys? I'm Tyler Brocious. My Bobcat of the Week, Ryan Scheiderman of the men's soccer team. A huge game-winning goal against the Fairfield Stags last week put the Bobcats as MAC regular season champions. We are here today for nothing more than PKs. Mano y mano, him and I think I'm saving him. Who knows? If he can get past me, he might lead his team to victory this week in the MAC tournament hosted right here at Quinnipiac. Team's been great all year. Let's see if he can beat me in some one-on-ones. As you guys can see, Ryan Scheiderman, absolutely no joke. Just the ball's in the net before I can even make a move. Victorious for him today. I'll give it up where credit's due. He dominated me. And hopefully, him and the Bobcats can dominate this weekend here in the MAC tournament. Back to you guys in the studio.
You know, I got to defend Tyler here for a second. I happened to be there in person to see that, and the ball was coming at him a lot faster and harder than I think we saw on that video. I think he should count himself lucky that he wasn't able to get in front of any of those.
You know, I lived with him for 3 years, and I got to say, I've never seen him do a split like that. But we transition. It is a big week ahead at home for the Quinnipiac teams. On Friday, the men's soccer team hosts Canisius in the semifinals of the MAC tournament at the QU soccer field, while the men's ice hockey team hosts Dartmouth on Friday and Harvard on Saturday at the TD Bank Center. Both games are at 7 p.m.
Meanwhile, basketball season gets underway, with both teams opening up at home. On Friday afternoon at 2 o'clock, the women's team opens their season against Florida Gulf Coast, while on Saturday, the men's team opens up against Vermont at 1 o'clock. And the women's rugby team begins their national title defense on the road against Westchester University, Saturday at noon in Westchester, Pennsylvania.
Big weekend of Quinnipiac sports ahead, huh, John?
Absolutely, I'd say so, Justin.
Well, that'll do it for us tonight, folks. We're going to take a 168-hour break. Have a great weekend.